Hi, I'm Ethni, a rising senior at the University of Delaware studying wildlife ecology and conservation at CANR. What inspired me to get into my summer scholars research with Dr. Angela Holland of the Wildlife Department is actually my current research with Professor Carla Guerrero Montero of the Anthropology Department at UD, who's co-authoring a book titled Why the Global South Needs Anthropologists. And the purpose of the book is to demystify any cultural biases coming out of the Global North and to bring more credit to voices of the Global South, bringing ethnographic reflections specifically from anthropologists that are working there and from there. And what inspired me through that is how that plays into wildlife. And I want to understand how different places like India and Asia and South America have their own experiences with this challenge that we face of improper messaging. And I want to shed light on the injustices of factory farming in America and how torturous it is and how it's just used to maximize profits at the expense of humans and animals alike, who are tortured by the underpaid workers and who are fed this hormone-pumped meat. And America is one of the most developed countries in the world, yet we're the most unhealthiest, and that is for a reason. So with Nestle, for example, they will go to underdeveloped countries and force them to sign over their land that has high soybean reserves, for example. And there are actually high soybean reserves in America and Australia, but that wouldn't be allowed there because then they would be obliged to pay comparable wages. And we see the dilemma with PETA and other animal rights groups and Aboriginal subsistence whalers who harvest whales in order to survive and don't have access to grocery stores because they are in a remote area, but are often shamed and looked down upon by these Western bred groups. So I'm gonna be interviewing these professionals from the Global South and just opening up a dialogue to demystify these cultural biases. And I'm grateful for this opportunity to continue my research through the Summer Scholars Program. Thank you. In the West, we do have an economic state where we could have used an alternative of eating meat, for example. We could eat organically grown non-GMO foods if we wanted to, because we do have those alternatives. We don't live in remote areas. So these abolitionist animal rights groups and welfare groups that we hear about, such as PETA, will kind of use the argument that people in the Global South are savages or they're mistreating animals solely because they are relying on the use of the resources that animals provide and they harvest them. And I would confidently say that indigenous peoples and people like the Aboriginal subsistence whalers of Alaska are the original conservationists, and we need to give them the credit they deserve, and we need to almost look for their truth through what is being fed to us by mainstream media in the West and in the Global North. So I'm very excited that I've been given this opportunity to continue research through Summer Scholars, and I'm excited to give you guys an update on how that turns out. Thank you.